All right, number two, we're asked to simplify the sine of the arc secant of 5 plus the arc tangent of 2. So once again, I'm going to associate each of these inverse trig functions with some angle and radian measure. We'll say alpha and beta. So alpha is the arc secant of 5. That means that the secant of alpha is 5. And because of the range of the arc secant gives us angles in quadrants 1 and 2, alpha's got to be an angle in quadrant 1 or 2. Since the secant of alpha is positive 5, I know that alpha's got to be in quadrant 1. All right, I'm going to let beta be the angle in radian measure associated with the real number arctangent negative 2. So that means that the tangent of beta is negative 2. And since arctangent gives us angles between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, the tangent is negative. I know that beta is between negative pi over 2 and 0. So I look at what I'm after up here. I want the sine of what? I want the sine of alpha plus beta. Okay, so now it's time for an identity. The sine of alpha plus beta is the sine of alpha times the cosine of beta plus the cosine of alpha times the sine of beta. And so to complete the problem, I need to figure out all these values. So let's look at alpha. I'm told that the secant of alpha is 5. So I can quickly get to the cosine of alpha. By taking the reciprocal, it's 1/5. So I've got the cosine of alpha, which is what I need here. Now I also need to get the sine of alpha. Well, time for Pythagorean identity. Cosine squared alpha plus sine squared alpha is 1. Cosine of alpha is 1/5. So when I square that, I get 1/25. And when I simplify this, I get sine of alpha. Well, let's see. 1 minus 1/25 is 24/25. I'm going to get plus or minus the square root of 24 over 5, which is plus or minus, I simplify this, 2 radical 6 over 5. But I know alpha is between 0 and pi over 2. That means alpha is a quadrant 1 angle. So I'm going to choose the positive. So that's everything I need to know about alpha. Now it's time to go looking at beta. I know that the tangent of beta is negative 2. And I need the sine and cosine of beta. So there are a couple different ways to go about this. I could go back to the definition. Tangent is the y coordinate over the x coordinate. I'll just use an identity. I know that 1 plus tangent squared beta is secant squared beta. And once I get the secant of beta, it's one step away from getting the cosine of beta. So I substitute this in. 1 plus negative 2 squared is secant squared beta. And looky looky, I get the secant squared of beta is none other than 5. So the secant of beta is plus or minus square root 5. Now, I look where beta is. Beta is between negative pi over 2 and 0. That means that beta is a quadrant 4 angle. And then that quadrant, the secant's positive. So that tells me that the cosine of beta is the reciprocal of the secant, so it's 1 over square root 5, or I could write that as square root 5 over 5. So last thing I got to get now is the sine of beta. One option is I could go through the Pythagorean identity. The other option is I can use the identity that the tangent of beta is sine of beta over cosine beta, which means that the sine of beta is the tangent of beta times the cosine of beta. The tangent of beta, I know, is negative 2. The cosine is radical 5 over 5. So this gives me sine of beta is negative 2 radical 5 over 5. And just as a quick check, since beta is in quadrant 4, I do expect the sine to be negative, so that checks. All right, so now I've got all the ingredients here to get my final answer. The sine of alpha is 2 radical 6 over 5. The cosine of beta is radical 5 over 5 plus the cosine of alpha is 1/5 times the sine of beta, negative 2 radical 5 over 5. So I'm going to get a common denominator here of 25, and I'm going to get 2 radical 30 here. I'm going to get minus 2 radical 5 here, and so that's about as nice as we can get it. 2 radical 30 minus 2 radical 5. So that'll do it for number 2. Okay, number 3, we're asked to simplify sine of 2 times the arc sine of 3x. So once again, we go in, and the arc sine of 3x is some real number between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, whose sine is 3x. I can associate that with an angle theta in radian measure. So theta is going to be the arc sine of 3x. And what do I know about theta? The sine of theta is 3x. And then I'm going to interpret theta as an angle between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So once again, if I'm thinking of this in terms of the unit circle, if theta runs between 0 and pi over 2, we're looking at angles in quadrant 1. If theta is between 0 and negative pi over 2, we're looking at angles in quadrant 4. Okay? Now, I don't know where theta is because x is a variable. If x is positive, that's going to give me a quadrant 1 angle. If x is negative, it's going to give me a quadrant 4 angle. So I go back to my original problem, and by letting theta be the arc sine of 3x, what I'm looking for now is the sine of 2 what? Theta. So I go back to my identities, and what's the sine of 2 theta? The sine of 2 theta is 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta. All right, well, the sine of theta I already have. All I need to do is find the cosine of theta. How do I get the cosine of theta? I use the Pythagorean identity. I know cosine squared of theta plus sine squared of theta is equal to 1. So cosine squared theta plus sine theta, don't forget we have to square the 3 and the x, is equal to 1. This gives me cosine squared theta is 1 minus 9x squared, which means the cosine of theta is plus or minus the square root of 1 minus 9x squared. Now we look to see where theta lives. Regardless if x is positive or negative, theta is either in quadrant 1 or in quadrant 4. That means that the cosine of theta is always positive. So that's, we're going to choose that, which means the sine of 2 arc sine of 3x is 2 times the sine of theta, 3x, times the cosine of theta, square root 1 minus 9x squared. And so when the dust settles, I get 6x times the square root of 1 minus 9x squared. So that'll do it for part 3.